Hi, so I am Anwen, and this is the first video blog for Wicked Wednesdays with the Water Witch. So, just a quick introduction. My name is Anwen, which is spelled Anwyn. If you drop the Y, then it's actually pronounced Anun, and it is the Welsh word for the underworld. Or the Summerlands. And I made a commitment to myself in 2013 to do a blog, or to write a blog, about once a month. And I actually fulfilled that commitment, except for I think 1 month. I think I did miss a month in there. But I actually was able to, some other months, produce maybe two blogs, three blogs, four blogs. So I considered in 2014 committing to doing a blog a week. But then I realized with the coven that I run and my dance troupe and school, as well as my herbal apprenticeship, that there was no way that I was going to be able to actually write a blog a week. So what I decided to do was commit in 2014 to doing a video blog, and it's going to be Wicked Wednesdays with the Water Witch. So if you don't know about me, or we haven't connected before, you can learn more about me at my website, which is waterwitchinthewest.com. And those have a lot of blogs in there. Some of it's on water magic, others just on my practice in general. So a little bit of background on me. I was raised in the church, and at 18 I decided that I needed to leave. And I did as soon as it was possible. And I actually, several years later, found Wicca and realized that it kind of described everything that I had already been doing. See, I'd been practicing magic, folk magic, and natural magic since I was very, very young. I also had my very first supernatural experience when I was six. And, I always believed that there was more to life than what I had been told. So at 18, when I left the church, I went on this journey of really finding myself, and it landed me at Wicca's doorstep. And I practiced Wicca for quite a while until I realized that it wasn't perfect for me. It just wasn't quite right. Before I realized that, though, I did formally study and was initiated into a tradition, and it was great training. And it really brought me to a new level, and I'm really grateful for that. However, as things sometimes go, covens and traditions don't work out. And after my initiation, I tried very hard to stay and continue my practice, but realized that it wasn't quite the right fit for me. And so I started finding more information on water witchcraft, and actually through the Avalonian traditions with Mara Freeman, it's really kind of solidified my path. So I'm going to back up a little bit. I lived in Japan for a while, and I also grew up in Daytona Beach, and I lived about 10 minutes from beach access in North Carolina, which was about on the Sound. So I've always been really close to sea areas, beaches. In Japan, I actually lived in Okinawa, and so it's a very small island surrounded by ocean. And I've always had a deep connection with water, and so I have my astrological sign is my sun is in Cancer. And my moon is in Pisces. So I do have a lot of water in my chart. There's actually more water than just that, but those are the two main ones. So I actually found Wicca while I was in Japan, and I had some great training with a good friend who still is very inspirational to me today, and he really introduced me to magic and witchcraft and ceremonial magic and folk magic, and I realized that everything that I had been doing my entire life was kind of summed up in these practices. And so when I moved back to the United States is when I formally went through my training in Wicca and was initiated into Wicca witchcraft and became a priestess. And that was a very important part of my life, but like I said before, it just didn't work out, and so I moved on into the Avalonian traditions, which are very, very watery. And after that, I actually moved to Arizona, which is in the middle of the desert. And so all my life, I have been around water. There was my late teens, I actually lived in Arizona as well, so I wasn't connected to water during those times, and they were actually very hard for me. And when I moved back to Arizona 2.5 years ago, I was really devastated because I really needed that water connection. And about that same time, I realized that I love the ocean, but I have more of a connection with fresh water. When I was in Daytona Beach, though, I spent so much time on the beaches. We actually lived on a backed up to a nature preserve, and it was all swampland, and I used to spend hours in the swamp and just digging around in the mud and the water with all the beautiful cypress trees. And so when I moved here, I felt very empty, and then I started looking for water. I needed to find water, and I needed to have that connection, and I realized that, you know what, we're made up of water. We have the Salt River, which is not too far from here, that I make regular visits to. About 2 hours away, we have a sacred well called Montezuma's Well. The rain. We actually do, very rarely, but it does happen, get hail. And after about a year of living in Arizona, I took a pilgrimage to the UK. And I spent some time at Bath and in Glastonbury and at some sacred lakes in Wales, Mother Shipton's Cave, which is also considered a holy well, and a few other places in the UK that were really associated with water. Loch Ness is one. I never made it to Orkney, but we did get to the tip of Scotland, and I did get to spend some time on the beach there. And I came back, and this experience combined with everything else really solidified my practice that water witchcraft was for me. Of course, I didn't really understand what water witchcraft was because I was so familiar with sea witchcraft, and I think that most people are familiar with sea witches. And sea witches work with the tides, the moon cycles, shells, sea creatures, sea plants that are living along the shores, sand, driftwood, anything that washes up on the shore. And though this practice is a big part of my own practice, it doesn't just stop there. Of course, I'm not very close to the ocean at this time, so I do make regular pilgrimages, I am fortunate enough to be only about 6 to 7 hours away from San Diego, and I also make trips to the East Coast. This last summer, we spent a week on the Chesapeake Bay, on the Calvert Cliffs, and it was absolutely beautiful. It just filled my soul. So, there are many people like me that have that pull and connection to the water, but don't get to have the privilege of living so close to the ocean. And so I started to really think about what my practice was and how I could connect with water. And this is how my water witchcraft came about. Anything that you can do with sea magic and seawater, you can do with fresh water. You can work with the rain, storms, the weather. You can work with flower essences. You can work with potions. There's so many different things that you can work with. Even in the UK, each of the rivers has a goddess connected to it. And so, you know, water is a living, flowing force. And it has so much energy behind it. And so my particular practice does include sea magic when I'm around there or with items that I have collected from the seashores. I also work with the fresh waters, of course, the holy waters from Glastonbury, both the chalice well, which I collected myself, and water from the White Well, as well as from Bath, and a few other places. And I work with fish, water birds, the list goes on and on. So I don't want to keep this too long. I don't want you to just listen to me rambling on about my life. So I'm just going to end here by saying that there's so much to water witchcraft. It doesn't just stop with water. It is connected to the plants and to the moon cycles and even the sun cycles. Everything is connected. And so this video blog is going to touch on many different things, and I hope that I can share part of my practice with you. It will touch on sea magic, water magic, gardening, potion making, goddesses. I am polytheistic, though I do tend to be more of a goddess worshiper. I do try and find balance and honor the male deities as well. So with that, I just want to say thank you for watching, and don't forget you can find out more about me at waterwitchinthewest.com, and I look forward to seeing you next Wicked Wednesday.